Let us now understand the bandwidth calculation for a series RLC circuit. You have already drawn a graph for variation of current with the frequency of alternating current source. Here we know that at resonant frequency 1 by root LC, the circuit current is maximum. And at half power frequencies omega 1 and omega 2, here omega 1 and omega 2 are termed as half power frequencies. When the current in circuit is 1 by root 2 times the maximum. So, if we are required to calculate the range of these frequencies delta omega, then we need to calculate the values of omega 1 and omega 2. Let's calculate it. As we know, in a series RLC circuit, always the RMS current is written as ERMS by Z. And if we calculate at resonance, we can write the value of Z is equals to R and the maximum current in circuit is ERMS by R. So here we can write when power is equals to PM by 2. We know that the current RMS current in circuit will be IM by root 2. So if we calculate the value of Z in the situation when IRMS is maximum by root 2, then we can substitute here IRMS is ERMS by Z. This is equals to I maximum is ERMS by R, so it will be root 2 R. So this implies we can see the value of Z we are getting is root 2 R. So when Z is equals to root 2 R, the power in the circuit will be half of the maximum and we know the value of Z we write as root of R square plus X square which is equals to root 2 R. This implies at half power frequencies, the value of X must be equals to either plus R or minus R. So, depending on the value of X, the reactance when it is equals to plus R or minus R, you can see at two stages, the value of Z becomes equals to root 2 R. So, the frequency omega 1 is the situation when the value of X is equals to minus R and omega 2 is the situation when X becomes equals to plus R. And the value of X we know it is written as omega L minus 1 by omega C. This should be equals to plus minus R which corresponds to frequencies omega 1 and omega 2. Now let's calculate the values of omega 1 and omega 2 on the next sheet. In continuation, let's discuss which we have studied right now that at angular frequency omega 1, the reactance omega L minus 1 by omega C can be taken as minus R and at frequency omega 2, omega L minus 1 by omega C must be equals to plus R. These are the quadratic equation which I am leaving for you as an exercise to calculate. The value of omega 1 which we are getting here will be minus R by 2L plus root of R square by 4L square plus 1 by LC. This we are getting. We are omitting negative sign in the quadratic root because frequency can never be negative. Similarly, here on solving the quadratic, you'll get the value of omega 2. Is equals to R by 2L plus root of R square by 4L square plus 1 by LC. Now from here we can calculate, we can write this bandwidth of circuit is this delta omega we can write omega 2 minus omega 1. And on substitution of these two values, we are getting the bandwidth is equals to R by L. This is a very useful relation. You should always keep in mind that bandwidth of a series RLC circuit, we can directly write as the ratio of resistance to the inductance. And using this bandwidth in upcoming sections, we are going to derive some more important parameters in alternating current.